rivers flow for everyone. Through your own backyard, down to the ocean they run. They start out small, they're big before they're done. If you better yourself, you better everyone.
Our environment has been good to us. It has supported us. It has nurtured us. Unfortunately, this has not been a two-way street. We have taken nature for granted. We took what nature had to offer and gave very little back. We have severely damaged our environment, our home. Now imagine going home to your house and finding a gigantic hole in the roof. How about this? Turning on your faucet at home, and mud and slime comes oozing out. About waking up in your room and it's so filled with dirt and smog that you have to wear a gas mask. Yes, these things might sound silly, but unfortunately they are very real. I'm not talking science fiction now. Scientists tell us that there's a hole in the ozone layer of our atmosphere. The ozone layer protects us from the harmful rays of the sun. Our waterways and our streams are filled with industrial waste. A major city in our country has a river running through it. That river has caught on fire twice. Carbon monoxide and other smoke has gotten into our rain and made it so acidic that when it enters our streams and ponds and lakes, it kills all of our fish. And in some places, our air is so polluted that on some days, the infirm and the elderly and the ill are told not to go outside because it's too dangerous to breathe. Yes, Todd?
Is there anything we can do?
I'm glad you ask. The future is in your hands. You have the power to change it. And when I say you, I mean each and every one of you. Yes, you can make a difference. Every little bit that you do can help. No, we won't change things overnight, that's for sure. But little by little, your efforts will bring exciting and positive results.
What are some of the things we can do?
Let's talk about some of the things we can do to help our environment in our home.
So, Todd, what do you think of today's class?
You know, it's really scary, all the stuff about holes in the atmosphere and ocean dumping. I have a baby brother, and if things are this bad now, I wonder how they'll be when he's my age.
So are you going to do some of the things that we talked about?
Of course I have to. We all do.
Hey, do you want to go get a soda?
Sure. What do you think of the slideshow?
It was just so amazing, the difference it can make, you know, yeah. Before and after. Hi, Pop.
Oh, hi, kids. How you doing? How you doing?
Good.
How was school today?
It was good. We talked about the environment.
Oh, the environment is always nice to talk about. And how was school for you today?
It was great.
I suppose you want a bag for these things now?
Please?
Wait a minute. Remember what we talked about today, Todd?
Yeah.
You should only ask for a bag if it's absolutely necessary.
It's only a small bag.
I know, but you're the one who's worried about what the environment's going to be like when your baby brother grows up. Right?
I guess you're right. Every little thing we can do will really make a change.
That's right.
Thanks, but no thanks. We don't need a bag.
Yeah, and Pop,
yeah.
Only ask your customers if they need bags if it's absolutely necessary.
Oh, sure,
okay?
Yeah.
And we're going to bring these bottles back tomorrow.
Ah, and meanwhile, you have a good day, eh?
You too.
Okay.
Bye, Pop.
Bye, kids.
Todd, I've got to go, okay?
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow, then.
But remember, recycle your bottles.
You bet.
Bye. Bye-bye. Hi, just in time to help with the groceries.
Yep.
What are you doing with that empty bottle?
I'm saving it for recycling.
Oh. Well, I'm sure your grandmother's glad I'm back. Little Joey's probably driving her crazy. Thanks. Got it?
Yep. Whew. Hey, Mom. Did you ever think about bringing your own bags to the supermarket?
What?
Yeah, it'd be a lot safer for the environment and easier, too.
For the environment? Is this my son talking?
Yep.
All right. You hungry?
Yeah.
So is that new teacher working out, Ty?
He was great. Today we saw slides on the environment. And then we talked about what we can do to help our environment. We can all do something.
Sounds like it was quite a class.
I think that's a great idea. We can all learn things to help our environment. And besides, I want him to grow up in a nice, healthy world.
That's what I thought about today. We have to do things now.
Okay, you convinced me. Now what can I do?
Well, the first thing you can do is to buy products with this label on it. That's the recycling logo. You know what that means? That means this product is made from recycled material. You should look for this mark before you buy any products.
I told you it was never too late to learn things.
And Mom, this is a no-no.
What?
Plastic plates. It's better to use our own plates.
Aw. Well, I guess I'm going to have to start washing dishes again, huh? Keep that in mind.
And Mom, these styrofoam cups are the worst. They're not biodegradable. You know what that means? These cups will be sitting around for hundreds of years.
What is biodegradable anyway?
Little microorganisms break down organic material over the course of time. It's nature's waste disposal system. The problem? Man's invention of non-biodegradable material, such as plastics.
I see. So, the microorganisms can't break them down then?
That's right. Even biodegradable material in plastic garbage bags won't be broken down for hundreds of years or longer.
Wow. This is serious.
The landfills where garbage is dumped are filled to the capacity. Even biodegradable material will take a long time to be broken down because of the congestion.
I guess I'm going to have to reorganize my entire shopping list.
I would say so.
Mom, make sure you read the labels on all the chemicals you buy. You should only buy cleaners and detergents with all natural ingredients in them. The ones with phosphates hurt the environment. This is good. Buying fresh vegetables and fruit is better than buying the ones that are packed in plastic or styrofoam.
Well, I'm glad to know I'm doing something right.
Take it easy. Rome wasn't built in a day. And here's another thing.
Is there something wrong with our faucet?
I never knew it, but we don't have an aerator.
An aerator?
Yeah, they're very easy to install. They screw right into the faucet, and they're very inexpensive. An aerator filters out tap water. An aerator can save thousands of gallons of water over the years.
I'll stop at the hardware store later.
My baby, there. Wait a minute. Now, Mommy's home. Here. Yes, don't be upset. Come on, Mommy. I think he has to be changed.
That's another thing.
Oh, don't tell me there's special diapers I'm supposed to buy.
Disposable diapers are a big problem in the landfill.
Really?
You should buy the cloth diapers. They're a lot cheaper.
Oh, yeah, but what about the pins?
Haven't you ever heard of Velcro?
Oh, even I've heard of that. You know, with Velcro, you can close the diaper and not worry about hurting the baby.
If you need disposable diapers, you should buy the biodegradable ones. They have biodegradable written on the side.
Well, you told us what we can do, but what do you plan to do to help?
Some of my friends and I are going to start up a magazine pool so we can share all our magazines. We're also going to start up a club at school for recycling. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out all the old clothes in my room that I don't wear anymore and put them in a clothing drop for homeless people.
You're kidding. Well, I've been trying to get you to clean out that closet for months.
Well, now I have a good reason to do it. It's for the environment. I'm going to go see what Jackie's doing.
That's my boy.
Beautiful. Never thought I'd see it.
Hey, Jack, what are you doing?
Drawing.
But there's hardly anything written on this paper, or these pages either.
I'm trying to draw something.
Do you ever think of using the backs of the paper? Sure, it's a lot better for the environment that way. What you do is you try to draw a good drawing, and if you mess up, just cross it out. When you do get a good drawing, just transfer it onto another piece of paper. You understand? In other words, look at this paper. You can draw a lot more on this paper. You can use the back of it, you can use all other sides of this paper. You understand? In class, we talked about what we can do to help our environment. Saving paper is one of them. Want to know what another thing is? The TV's on, and you're not even watching it. When you shut the TV off, you're conserving energy. When it's on and you're not watching, you're wasting energy. We should all start right now trying to reduce waste and save our energy. Okay?
Hi, Dad. What are you doing?
Hi, Todd. Would you pass me that flashlight, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
What's up?
I'm changing the oil.
Are you going to use recycled motor oil?
What?
Recycled motor oil.
I never heard of it.
Today in class, we learned about what we can do to help the environment. One of the things we can do is to use recycled motor oil. I think it's new, but we should check with our local stores to see if they carry it.
Well, sounds good to me.
We should also contact the state and see if our local solid waste office will take our old motor oil.
Todd, you sound very serious about all this.
I am. This is really important. Every little thing someone does can really make a difference.
What other kinds of things can we do?
We can retread our tires. Retreaded tires last almost as long as new ones, and they also cut down on the demand for rubber.
Well, that's a good idea.
And you know, when our battery's worn down, we can go for a trade-in. See, the chemicals in car batteries are very dangerous for the environment.
That's another good idea. Now, what about other batteries for things like appliances and flashlights?
They are also very bad for the environment. What they do is corrode and release metals into the ground, which eventually gets sucked into our water system. What we should do is find out where we can bring our old batteries. Until then, we should use rechargeable batteries, which are a lot cheaper. And Dad, that's another thing. You shouldn't use paper towels. You should use cloth towels or sponges. They're a lot...
I know. Cheaper in the long run.
And better for the environment.
And do you think after we start saving and everything, I can maybe get a raise in my allowance?
Hey, Todd, I'm proud of you. I know there's a lot of things the whole family can do to help out. I tell you what, why don't we get in the truck and take a ride and see if we can go find some of that recycled motor oil?
Great.
Come on, son.
Take a look over there.
Hi, Mr. Collins.
Hi, Todd. I see you've got the whole neighborhood involved in recycling.
I'm spreading the word.
Good. What have you got for us today?
All different types of paper.
Well, let's put it on the belt. That's it. Dump it in. There you go. That's it. Dump it all on.
Mr. Collins, how does this all get recycled?
Well, Todd, there's so many types of paper that we have to separate it into different grades. Now, when we get enough of one grade, we put it on the conveyor belt, and it all gets compacted.
How do you know when you have enough?
Look over there. You see those numbers increasing? Well, we know we have enough when those numbers reach between 13 and 16. Then we stop the conveyor belt, and all this paper gets compacted. Wayne, why don't you get me some hats? Here, put your hat on. Does everyone have a hat? Could you put them on, please? Now, if you follow me to the back, I'll show you what happens to all this paper after it gets compacted. Follow me.
Everyone stay together.
Follow me. All right. Is everyone here?
Yes.
Good. Now, after all that paper gets compacted, it gets sent out right here. Now, you see these bundles? They are compacted so tight that if you set a match to it, only the outside of it would burn.
That's how the landfills are right now. Certain items won't be broken down for hundreds of years or longer.
That's right.
What happens to these bundles?
Well, these bundles get shipped out to paper mills across the country, which get made into other paper products. As a matter of fact, there's a truckload going out today. First, each of these bundles get weighed, and then they get loaded onto the trucks, which get sent out to mills across the country and overseas. Now, thanks to people like you and Todd here, our business is booming.
It's only the start. We have a long way to go.
The rivers flow for everyone, through your own backyard, down to the ocean they run. They start out small, they're big before they're done. And if you better yourself, you better everyone. The rivers flow for everyone, through your own backyard, down to the ocean they run. They start out small, they're big before they're done. And take one step, the hard part's done. The ocean a big cool place. It started out blue, it's getting blacker every day. The rivers flow from everyone, from your own backyard down to the ocean they run. To the ocean they run. To the ocean they run.
We started our recycling program 3 weeks ago, and already the effect upon our community has been tremendous. These are just some of the grateful responses we've received. We even have a letter from the mayor thanking us for showing what can be done if everyone does their part. He even wants to talk to us about implementing our program on a larger scale. I'm proud of all of you. But we've only scratched the surface. There are many more things to be done. Let's talk about some of those things right now.